And on the left side on Cursed Hollow, we have our German SC2 Pro team composed out of Zocke on Zagara, Hasuops on Tychus, Hiruki on Abathur, Balfurion is played by Pausenclown, and Nomi is playing the Authors, and they're called Well Met.
And on the right-hand side, in the red trunks, we have Fast Forward with Ufa, played by Marco Wynn. We have Reyna, played by Saiheya. Vongola, who is on the ETC for some reason. Sebkeya is once again on his patented Nova, and Gela is playing the Tyrael in the bottom lane.
Yeah, and Well Met is moving out as a team.
Well Met's moving out as a team, whereas Fast Forward, already spotted out by Nomi, who was hiding in that bush. We see Vo saw Vongola wander over there with ETC, but not choose to face check or engage. So we're not going to see it too much there. Tychus still not revealing himself, and Vongola is actually hanging here, waiting for Tychus to reveal himself so that they can farm some XP. Tychus actually needs to get there, gets the XP for the minion.
Yeah, and already we see the creep spread starting out here. Zagara doing a really good job. Zocke must have trained his Zerg play as well. And this gives him amazing map vision. Let's have a look at their vision already. And you can see, like, they're almost on top of everything here. Ooh, wow,
Oh.
they took out Tychus in the middle.
And
Wow, the
that's
gank squad
ETC,
worked
ladies and
out.
gentlemen. ETC ganks.
They work out.
They work out. So
Yep.
let's see. We're gonna see Fast Forward walk into every single mine on the way to top lane. This is pretty huge for what Well Met are doing. However, they will know that this is now coming. Sokke and Pausenclown are just gonna try and push this as much as possible. Marco Wynn being forced to play a bit further back, but Well Met also gonna play it safe and back up a bit, waiting for the wave to push back in their favor.
Yeah, so far, just going on with the laning and another mine hit here on Shabaki, and that gave Hasuops the heads up here in the middle lane. So he's safe. So having that map vision really helps them out a lot.
Indeed, it does. And I honestly thought Vongola was actually going to go for the fountain there, and I was like, what? You have like a sliver of mana missing, but he was just running past it because he could. But they are now going to go for their easy. And this is what Well Met are going to have a bit more difficulty with. They're going to have to actively send maybe two people from lane because Abathur is going to slow down their cap. Zagara appears pretty set on pushing this top lane rather than going for mercenaries.
Yeah, they're doing a good job here, Malfurion and Zagara. Almost got the gate already. I think it's gonna fall in with this, with this little push wave. They're gonna get it, and both towers are actually completely out of ammo.
They're gonna take them as well before the tribute even finishes spawning. Tribute spawns, towers are down, and they are now gonna roam in that direction. Doesn't look like either of the bot lane. I stand corrected. They both just mounted up as I said that, and they're gonna head there. Gela choosing to kill a minion on the before that happens.
Oh, Malfurion missing this root, but still keeping ETC on the run. And there's just the mirror here for Nova. And Arcus moved in, but
yeah,
he's
Nomi,
completely out of position.
Interesting pathing there. He went a bit the wrong way, and Nomi does go down. Hasuobs going to try and get a bit of harass onto Gela, but being forced to back up. And Saiheya cancels the overdrive. Pausenclown also being forced to back up. And Vongla has found Sokke with the help of Marco Wynn. They're trying to burst him down to Sebkeya. Helps pick him off, and we're seeing a lot of positioning faults here from Well Met.
Yeah, they're kind of divided on in the entire map, and it's not really the fault of the composition, but rather, yeah, pathing issues, as you said.
It's not so much pathing issues as you right-clicked in the wrong place and didn't choose to be safe.
Yeah, exactly that. And even though they have that map vision, they can't really use it right now.
Oh my god, Abathur's playing the annoying Abathur build. Hiruki is playing the build that I like to call the annoying Abathur build because he's going utility Abathur with such talents as Promote.
Okay.
Do you have any idea how annoying it is having your wave pushed by really strong Locust and Promoted minions while he can still copy one of your heroes? Very irritating. Also, Saiheya with some interesting starter step.
I'm kind of wondering why they have Nomi still in lane then. Because Abathur could just solo push this if he wants to.
He could, but he won't get the XP from it.
Okay. That's true.
Also, he's top lane at the moment.
Yeah, he just switched things around.
Yep.
That works out. And Zagara is back. Push a creep spread.
While this is happening though, Fast Forward once again gathering mercs, which are Well Met not really doing. They got there easy. That's about it. They're very much behind in the merc game. But Sokke finally looks like he might be willing to leave his lane, but he just seems too reluctant to do it. And there's the tribute. Oh, that's a good place for Wellmet.
Yeah, really amazing placing for Wellmet. But they're still pushing this top lane, and now ETC is moving in, and it's just Malfurion and Zagara. They should be safe though. Oh, nice stun and the pushback as well.
There's the Ufa stun. Nope, was a bit too far forward. And once again, Vongola, for the second time, being dropped hugely low. There's the shield from Ufa. And now
Nova might fall though! Ooh, really
if
nice
you use
done.
Your shield on your warrior, then you're not going to be able to save your assassin. And Vongola does live. But Semkea, the damage source here, does go down. Now we're going to see Sai here go down as well. And this is a good fight for Wellmet. Geller also being dropped low. There's the overdrive. Sloan is coming down from Nomi. And once again, for the first time, we're going to see Wellmet take control of this game. And they're going to grab their first tribute.
Yeah, nice turnaround in the team fight, kind of luring them in and then just finishing them off one by one. And I like that the split decision they did up there. Wow, Uther might fall here. Whoa, no, there comes the heal.
Oh, they got him.
Wow, nice not watching out at all here in the top lane. He really wanted to save that fort, and it's not going to work whatsoever.
Yep, and top fort is now down. We're seeing Aswabs getting sniped. Oh, Aswabs stuck in Moonwalk, but is able to mount up to cancel that. So that bug we'll see, but it looks like we're gonna see Wellmet already go into fast forward jungle and attempt to take their golem. There's the clairvoyance, so Wellmet fast forward know 100% this is happening, but they're not gonna. Oh, now they're gonna react to it.
They're coming in from all sides. Reyno's coming in from top. It looks like they want to focus him out, but Hasselops, can he block him? Yes, he can, and there comes the heal. Going into his own form.
I'm pretty sure that was. I don't think that was the real one. That was, in fact, the hologram. Sai here, precision strikes onto Nomi, doesn't really do any damage. They were able to pick up Raider, who was a bit out of position. Hiroki in the clone is just distracting everyone at the moment. We're still going to see a huge.
Nova's so close to dying down there.
A lot of people just left or DC'd.
Yeah, looks
that's
like,
pretty
wow.
Bad timing for Wellmet. Soke has been abandoned by his bot friends, and he's gonna get picked up by Jella and Vongola, Arthas and Malfurion bot.
Wow,
horrible,
they're just
horrible timing.
Yeah, not really impeccable timing for the bots to take over. Otherwise, they could have saved themselves, I think. And
they could have
this
at
was
least
actually
saved Soke there.
Yeah, and this was an amazing fight for Wellmet until all the bots turned.
They had that. They probably could have got the golem as well after killing them off, but they lost Soke for that instead of what could have happened of being an amazing fight. That was super, super unlucky. Both teams lost a lot of players, but it was the wrong players for Wellmet. Wrong place, wrong time.
Let's try. Let's see if they can. Let's try this again, but Nova's in position to spot this out. Zagara, let's see, maybe she can stop them.
Oh. Zagara can see Sebkea at that point, and they're going to attempt to take the golem.
But even though they've been scoured, that's actually really ballsy.
There's a slight level advantage in the favor of Wellmet. They could all go in, possible could go in here. Abathur has not ultimate evolution. Oh, the mosh pit! Onto two players, there's the precision strike, hits two, takes out Arthas, the golem. Has been taken by blue team Wellmet, but fast forward are likely going to get a lot of kills for this. Hasselobs does get picked off, and now it is Soke versus Geller here. Nice devouring more, and that's going to keep Soke alive. But super good engaged by fast forward. They may have lost the golem, but they gain the map control, they gain the damage. However, Amethyst is stealing the tribute.
Oh, I don't know if this works out. I think he will get it.
He gets it, but can he get out is the question. He gets the curse, which will protect coverage for a while. There's the clairvoyance. They see him. Marco Wynn has given chase.
Oh, it's not going to work.
Yep.
But I don't think that was worth it. For the first curse?
For the first curse, which will give his team enough time to respawn and now contest the golem of fast forward. In the meantime, their golem is pushing the bot lane uncontested except for Raider. Thanks to the curse, the minions in the top bot lane will die, and they get a fort for it. And now
the next fight's coming in. Good Vivine Storm here by Uther, but everyone's just jumping in. Hasselops still on cooldown apparently, and whoa, I don't know if this was the right decision. They weren't even there with an entire team, and now everyone's just mounting up. Hasselops looks like he can save himself.
They got burst pretty hard. They did not have enough damage and enough tankiness in that comp. The golem did push pretty far, but wasn't able to get another gate. That curse has delayed, at least, the push of fast forward, who would have been a lot more brutal if that curse hadn't come down, but that's a lot of kills given over. It's now double the kills for fast forward compared to Wellmet.
Yeah, but they have two forts down, so I think it was kind of a good trade for them, at least grabbing that final tribute. And they're gonna grab the hard camp now. Not to have that stolen. And make another little push, grabbing the easy camp before. And maybe they can get a surprise attack on the boss.
Maybe. Boss wasn't taken in that fight. It was at least cancelled while all that was going on. I'm just going to have a look at the talents before we do this here. Reyna has taken both Searing Attacks and Giant Killer, so he's going to drop as much damage as possible. Hard camp taken by Fast Forward.
Nice stun here on Nomi. And Tychus moves in from the top. And wow, Ufa taking a lot of damage, but the amazing Divine Storm. Can he get out? Yeah, the Maw saves the day, and Mafurin tries to get away, getting three players in that Maw, but Hasuops also low. Hiruki takes all the damage though, and so Hasuops can shoot him from the back, and there's a nice little attack by him.
Yeah, Mosh Pit missed pretty much everyone, as did Precision Strike, but Fast Forward still have a bit of damage, but they're all so low and well met. Gonna clear up the fight finally. Are they actually gonna try and take the Golem here as well? Yes, they are. They have bolts of steel at this point.
Well, I mean, they have four players down. They can take that risk if they want to. They're only missing Arthas, which is somewhat of a big deal, but I think they do have the damage output to kill the boss without any real issues. And I gotta give it to the Odins right there. They really want that fight for well met.
Yeah, the Odins dropped a huge amount of damage, and I would like to point out, there was quite a bit of misplay from Fast Forward there. They tried to get a good fight, but Precision Strike was used on absolutely no one, attempting to kill off Tychus, who was zoning a lot of the members of Fast Forward, but it completely missed when Tychus backed out, and the Mosh Pit also hit no one, completely whiffed. He just had to instantly cancel it and go back in, but by that point, they were all too low. All their wombo combo abilities were used apart from each other, and all of them missed.
And that's one of the problems with this wombo combo combination. I mean, they need to jump in there, and they need to do it early on in the fight. If they do it later on, they don't have the sustain to actually keep it up and get them down fast enough.
Yep, this is the problem. Whereas we've seen there, well met. They're going to take a four here. That's all three tier one forts for well met, as opposed to zero for Fast Forward. This is really looking good for well met, and we've seen in that fight, once we have two Odins and the Hunter Killers from Sokke, they have a lot of sustained damage.
Oh, we have a couple of mobs pushing here, and
also I'd like to point out how Tassadar took Tranquility just to keep his team alive that little bit longer, which is working out fantastically.
Yeah, they're doing it really well, and here comes the counter push.
Oh, careful now, you can't mount up now.
It's quite dangerous here.
Yeah, bit risky. Looks like they're all just going to back up, play it safe, mount up behind their walls, and get ready for an engagement. All the players are here, except Abifa, who's top lane.
I think Nobi wants to set a trap, but
Abifa's here.
Mm-hmm. No, they got the ultimate. Ultimate already pushed. I think they should be even moving in from both sides. No, but Tychus is coming in from the back. There's the Cold Strike. Not doing all too much. I think they just want to stop the Siege Giants, and then they're going to be good to go. That's just a clone.
Tribute is available.
Oh, and again on Wellmet's side.
Yeah, it doesn't even look like Fast Forward are going to even bother. They backed up to their side of the map. They're going to clear minions.
They might actually bother now.
They're going to try. Oh god, they're not even taking tribute, they're taking the Golem, and now they're going to contest. One Odin has already been popped, but will not have too much duration.
Oh, they're going to contest
it. Oh my god, yes.
Wow, what a steal!
Using Smite as the knockback, and taking down Tassadar Geller, the star of this engagement so far. The Devouring Maw did hit a lot of players, but it's not going to be enough. Hasselwobs gets popped out of Odin, the Tranquility did keep him alive for a bit. Nice grenade as well, he may in fact save his team. We're seeing Vongala charging in, but he's not going to be able to get it. Incredible engage there. Geller, absolutely the star. Really nice ult from Sokke, but nowhere near enough to catch out the team and stop that incredible steal and that incredible fight.
Yeah, that was truly an amazing way to play this. And also, gotta give it to Hasuops here. He really saved his team's ass. I mean, if those two would have gone down, this might have already put their forts in the main camp in danger. But we do have the steal on the hard camp now, which is a little bit bad right now, since they were already down a couple heroes, and now they got to deal with the pressure that's coming in on the bottom lane and the middle lane.
very much so. This game is so close. If well, if Fast Forward can get the top fort of apparently the top keep of Fast Forward went down, so that's unfortunate for them. Abifert doing his job.
And now they have catapults on the top lane, and I think Wellmet is gearing up to take the last tribute. Wow, that would be
a team fight. We're gonna see a team fight.
Yeah, we have to see it. ETC is already coming in.
Results. Oh, there's a lot of Wellmet ults down here. Ultimate evolution's been used. Tranquility
just a couple
is not ready.
More seconds,
Odin is just about to be ready. Devouring Maw's not ready.
They need to stall. They need to stall for a little bit. Odin is ready.
Nice to fight Storm, but it didn't hit either of the Tychuses. Hasselhoff, though, is about to be popped out of his straight away. And there's the wonderful mosh pit onto Odin number 2. Odin number 2 is gonna be popped.
Oh, Tychus falls, though. Nova falls. ETC is the only one left alive. He kicks up a little bit damage, gets Zagara down. And wow, there comes the kill on Zagara and Arthas in that fight. And they're gonna steal the tribute. Good job.
Yep, and I think that mosh pit was worth. He only hit one, but it was one Odin. A temporary thing that still times out when you mosh pit. Very well played. And that is finally their first curse. So Fast Forward are going to spend what looks like the majority of this curse cleaning up the mess that Wellmet have left for them.
It does look like it. They're going to move out, maybe grab their boss. They have like a 16 second cooldown on both their heroes. Probably safer just to grab the hard camp for now.
Yeah, they're grabbing the hard camp, gonna be able to steal that while this is going on. And Wellmet, they're just respawning, they're regrouping, they're getting ready for when the next fight happens. They're still pretty even in levels. All this time, Abifer has been active on the map, throwing down Locusts, teleporting in, deep tunneling into lanes, just to get that little bit of extra XP. And I'd like to point out, when Abifer promotes a minion that has been cursed, it gets a lot of health back. So that's actually really helpful.
Yeah, one way to actually keep the lane alive somehow. And one thing to note though, that Zagara hasn't actually been putting out the creep tumors now in the late game. They never actually got the chance to set up a solid positioning again for them. So the real map vision advantage is gone a little bit. Now only the mines are left, and I think Abifer has been busy just keeping this lanes alive.
Yeah, Abifer has been doing huge work for Wellmet, but now there is a Golem and a Fast Forward comp in the top lane, and that fort pretty much dead. I don't see Wellmet reacting to this, and they're not. They're just going to charge down the mid lane and attempt to get a keep for this. This is greedy. This is so greedy, but they're going to try and do it. But as we can see, Fast Forward all just going to press that B button and head out. But Wellmet, good reaction to this. They're just going to run away. They just forced a couple ports. Not all of Fast Forward did port, but enough of them have ported to stop this push in the top lane, which leaves Arthas and Malfurion to deal with this Golem.
Yep, they shouldn't have too many problems now, and both teams are almost at level 20 at the same exact time. Whoa, what a balanced matchup.
It's a very bad matchup, but I really, really would like to iterate. Very, very nice pseudo-aggression there out of Wellmet. It really saved them there. They could have lost so much in that top push. They definitely would have lost this gate and maybe both the towers and maybe another team fight if they'd been forced to team fight there. But the pseudo-aggression forced a couple ports, which made that they can now gain a bit of map control back.
Amazing fake out. They might lose out on their own boss though. Everyone out of Fast Forward is already in position. They already have the concave set up. They're gonna go for the boss.
They're ready.
Where's Wellmet? Just now moving in.
They're sneaking in. Clairvoyance will be dropping down soon to try and scout out the Wellmet comp. Oh, there's the ult. Yabifer ult has been popped. They don't have vision of this yet. Now they
it's
do.
It's their time now. Arthas moves in. He gets a couple shits off.
Oh, Divine Hurricane. That was an amazing Divine Hurricane. There's Odin number one. Odin number
two. The Maw gets everyone in there. Markwin is in there. Vankulas in
there. Get in the circle. They're in the circle. Oh, it's so close. The Wellmet are going to get it. There's the mosh pit. But it's not going to be enough. Sebkia will drop. Nice bolt of the Stormdome by Soke there for style. Vonga, the last one alive. He doesn't go down. He bolted and stormed over the wall. And he's going to run for his life. But solid Wellmet fight there. Completely taking down the team of Fast Forward. They're being forced to back out. Vongler desperately trying to escape. Gets knocked up. Getting focused down by the Hunter Killers. Can he escape? He does have a heal. He does have a fountain, which is on cooldown, apparently.
And Turo's moving in. Oh, Zarkus might be... Ooh, Zarkus in trouble.
Yeah.
Good job. I mean, Zaka just overextended way too much there, and they grabbed the boss in that fight. So, good job. Well met. Really used their timing to their advantage, and yeah, just impeccable how they went in there. And I gotta say, the Maw really saved them here.
The Maw saved them so much. That Divine Hurricane really, really put them in trouble. They would have been so boned if that Maw hadn't at least stopped the damage on them while they were in that Hurricane. And the Mosh Pit only catching Malfurion. Very, very solid play there by Wellmet. And that Golem was so close. It was a fingernail's width from going over to Fast Forward. But Wellmet, they reacted. They got in that circle as quick as possible, and they were able to take it. Incredible play. This match is fantastically close.
Yeah. And they just now stopped the boss, so that's about the time they need to grab the hard camp and just go for the other camps as fast as they can. I mean, next up is going to be the easy camp, 1:10. Boss on the other side, also 1:10, and 10 seconds on the hard camp for Fast Forward, though I doubt that they're going to go for that. It's going to be a fight for the tribute again on the lower lane here.
They have to get this tribute. If this curse happens, it's probably game over. Nice! Oh,
nice disrupt there.
There's the ult onto Tychus, though, and this
is bad. Arthas is trapped on the right side. They're going to focus him out. There comes the Divine Storm. Amazing way to do this. Arthas is getting taken out, and now they're just going to follow it up. Focus goes down on Zagara. She should be Oh, no. She's going down. Malfurion goes down, and now everything just snowballs. They're not gonna take that tribute. And Hasuab's surviving for a really long time. Taking out Ufer. Wow. Abathur really helping out there.
Yeah, Abathur and Tychus, they're actually getting work done. Arthas is,
I don't know what Arthas is doing.
I think he died and respawned with Resurgence and then tried to come to the tribute and was like, okay, yeah, I don't want to be here. So was trying to find somewhere else to go. While this is happening, though...
The core health already down to 60%.
Those catapults, that's a promoted catapult as well in the top lane that just died. So that's been doing a lot of work. 54% left. And that was a good fight here by Fast Forward.
Oh, it looks like Arthas will get Fizzai. Oh, Reyna goes down.
Yep.
Well, nice pickup there. They really need all the heals they can get.
Oh, nice. Very nice heal there. Those Banshees, though, they're persistent.
I didn't even notice that. Luckily enough, Abathur was on him.
There we go. There's a duration up. If Abathur had a good on him, though, he would have been able to heal himself, but that would have been very annoying. And now, both teams just beginning to respawn. The team of Wellmet will be up in full first. I like what Abathur's doing. A lot of Abathurs like to do this. Go in there and let Locust tank while they take the camps. Malfurion going to wander in there and help.
Think that they might let this tribute go.
Who?
Oh, no. Now they're in position now.
Fast Forward won't because they are... Fast Forward will let it go because they don't have Reyna. They'll harass with Nova, but they definitely won't try and take it.
Yep.
There we go. Here's Wellmet. They may even try to catch out Nova. Nope, Sevkr is gone. So out of there.
They're waiting on the... Oh, they're waiting on the gathering. I don't know if that's the right idea. They could have already gotten it. Ooh, there's the interrupt.
They have to deny it. This curse could probably end the game. They'd have to fight this. But Paul St. Cloud gonna try and do it. Can the snipe it over the wall? No! Interrupt!
Oh, Nova! Wow, completely out of position. And now they're just gonna grab the boss and I think finish the game?
Yeah, that's GG. That is the end of the game. There's already Giants in this top lane. We're going to see them get the thing. And what Nova was trying to do there is she was trying to get to the other side of the wall to snipe over it to deny it. But one of the Tychuses saw her and revealed her. And that is what got her killed. She is now down for the remainder of this fight. Abathur clone is just going to wreck people until the timer runs out or he dies, whichever comes first. And now Blue Team's 4 is already under attack. There's two catapults, one promoted in the bottom lane. Top lane is being cleared, but there's still a Giant left and an entire comp of Wellmet.
Fast Forward is completely on the run. They need to somehow stop this, maybe with a nice Divine Storm. Is he still on cooldown? No. Looks like he's fine.
What a maw!
That should be it. And there's the final blow. Wellmet taking the first game here in the finals. What a game.
What a game indeed. Nuke for style at the end there as well. And Sokke devouring Maw's top job. the ETC, as much as I was excited to see the pick, didn't really work. Just he wasn't able to get those clutch mosh pits like he would want to get. Didn't work out in the end. And unfortunately, that's going to put a lot of people off ETC, even though it actually might have worked if they'd got some better engages with it.
Yeah, I mean, the initial team fights went really well for them, but I think later on, with Zagara really heating up and putting on the pressure with Amar, she saved like 3 or 4 team fights there.
Yeah, Zagara was a huge clutch in that. Definitely MVP. On the side of Fast Forward, Jella was definitely the MVP for that clutch golem steal. But it just didn't work out in the end. But it's a best of 3 series, so Fast Forward have their chance to bring it back.
Indeed they do. And I'll have to be taking a little bio break, so I'll be right back.
I do as well, so I will also be right back. So you might want to put an advert on.
Yeah, let's put an ad on.
Cool.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with the second game here in the ESL Community Cup number 8. I'm G-Shock. With me is Thatcher. We'll be right back. Alright, and we're back with the ESL Community Cup number 8. I'm G-Shock. With me is Thatcher. At least I hope he's with me. And I do have a couple replays from the fights of that first match. I mean, this is really shaping up to be an impeccable series. And a really close series. So let's see what the next map is going to be. And if they already have a lobby set up.
There is no lobby set up, and they haven't told me the next map yet.
Awesome. So you can have an eye out
for
that.
I will keep an eye on that, yes.
And we'll have a look at some of the fights that have been going on. I just got to check which fights we actually captured here. Skipping through. I'll let you guys know what's going on. There we go. Better. Okay, and I think this was the fight at the boss. So this was the initial engage by Uther, getting a good stun off. And I think this was the fight you were talking about before, where the stage the mosh pit actually came way too late. So we have a well met, kind of divided on this left side by the trees here. But also fast forward, not moving in at the same time. And now we have Zocke, Hasu Ups, and Nomi all gathering up on top here. And I think this was a pretty good Divine Storm here, but the Odin just dished out a lot of damage, and the Maw really saving the day again, getting three players in there. And now Hiroki is doing a really good idea. He's jumping into the Odin and tanking a lot of damage here. He's blocking the entire path, tanking a lot of damage. Hasu Ups can stay alive, and now the really badly timed mosh pit, and it's already almost Arthas is gone, but it's still pretty uneven fight since we have both Odins still in the fight. Now the first one falls, and other Odin comes in from the top again. And I love how well Matt always moves back and re-engages on their terms. Now they're following everyone, and we have Hasu Ups just engaging the entire mob here. Everyone's just clumped up, so his grenades do an extra bit of damage. And now it's Malfurion and Zocke that put out the pressure here on top. And everyone's just so low. I mean, Raynor falls, ETC falls, and then, I mean, Tyrael, he can't really take that much of a beating. And he goes down as well. Did he? I thought
Nobby is up.
Oh, sweet. Even better. Alright, I'll join you then.
Excellent.
And have they started banning yet? I don't think they did.
They have not.
Good. So I can show another video while we're waiting?
I would say so.
Okay. Let's have a look at this fight. Actually, I want to see the fight where they stole the boss. Might have happened down here. Nope, that's a different one. This was the "we want to get you while we're retreating" fight.
We want to get you.
Nope. Yep, okay. This is the fight where they're going for the boss. Now everyone moves in. I mean, this was kind of risky to take anyways. And the boss is already so low. Now Tyrael jumps in there, and he just grabs it. Incredible. I do have to say Nova's ultis didn't really hit this game as well as they should have. But they always take out Arthas first, doing a good job at that. And I think in this fight, what really changed it is that Zagara's Maw didn't do all too much. And then she went down, and now everyone's on the retreat. And I liked how Hasu was blocking everyone, keeping Pausen Clown and himself alive. Otherwise, this situation might have blown up in their face. All right, so
we have our first ban.
Oh, sweet! Let's go for the bans then.
All right, first ban from Fast Forward is Abathur.
Abathur, good idea.
Yeah, he's pretty good at the moment. He's pretty common in a lot of games we're seeing.
Banning him out, really consistent
limits
pick.
The options.
Okay.
And Stitch is banned. Also, someone we've seen banned pretty much every time.
Stitches was the ban for Well Met, and Abathur for Fast Forward. And, well, considering that last game, they need to ban Abathur or possibly even Zagara, so I think that's a good idea.
Indeed. So, it's a nice ban to see, and I'm sorry, my throat has just gone horrible after that little coughing fit I had. There we go. So, first picks, likely a Tassadar, likely a Tychus, maybe an Ufa. We're going to see fairly standard picks from these teams.
Yeah, as we have so far, Fast Forward did go for the most standard play in the semi-final. So I wouldn't expect anything else. And this is a different map, and this is their map choice this time around. So they probably have something up their sleeve.
This may indeed be the case, and that was a bit. The last
Uther.
Map was super close. Ufa, not surprising as the first pick. There's Hiroki, yep. So we finally have all our players in. So Uther is not a surprising first choice, but that is going to mean that Tassadar and Tychus have been given away to the team of Wellmet, and that's exactly what they're going to pick up. And that leaves their next support pick as Rhaegar. So they, if they wanted to, they could go for the Bloodlust comp that we saw Enfacuity running, but they didn't pick Bloodlust on.
Okay, so we had Uther as the first pick for Fast Forward, and now Tassadar and Tychus moving in for Wellmet. Okay,
now we play the waiting game.
Okay, going for the assassins right away. Did we have Tassadar in there? Previous matches?
Nope, no, Tassadar wasn't in the last match.
Nope. And before that, we don't know. I think we saw it on Monday. I think they played Tassadar. And I think they even had Hasuops playing the Tassadar. But Hasuops was on Tychus this time. So maybe it's going to be Zocker that plays the Tassadar now.
Maybe. Still hovering over stuff. Still waiting for stuff. First of all, they have Uther. I expect one of their pickups here to be Tyrael. They could, in fact, go for a similar comp to last time and just instantly take Tyrael Nova and just have that combo straight away.
Well, they could go for Tyrael. I doubt they go for Nova right away, because we've already seen two assassins taken by Wellmet. But then again, they do have that second ban. And also, Nova wasn't as good in that last game. She started out really well, and then later on, I don't know, her heroics didn't matter that much in the fights.
This is true. I think they can do well if they just play Nova a little bit more solidly than they did. When she did well in the fights, she did a fantastic job.
Yes. So, I mean, if everything works together, if you get the perfect storm, if you get the nice stage dive, and then just go for the precision strike. If everything works out fine, it's an amazing composition. But if just one of those components is missing, just so-so.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to go for Arthas Tyrael. Fairly standard, double warriors, getting their tankiness out, and just getting the first picks on warriors, taking them away from Wellmet. So Wellmet's going to have to go a bit more alternative in terms of warriors.
Yeah, Arthas Tyrael, solid warrior pickups, which does leave the ban on Nova still open, if that's going to occur soon.
Yeah, I would expect a ban on Nova if they have the chance. In fact, I'd almost 100% ban Nova, just remove the chance of that combo coming down, and that would leave their comp open to Bloodlust. They could, in fact, take Rhaegar now just to get that comp out, because then, unlike all they have left, is warriors. So yeah. And Fast Forward already have their two warriors. So if Fast Forward, they will probably ban Rhaegar away if they don't pick it. So now it might actually be a good time, and they're just going to have to deal with slightly worse warriors than they would otherwise have.
If they don't pick Rhaegar now, I think he's going to be banned. Either him or Zagara, weirdly enough. But
maybe.
Asu and Zocca played Tassadar in every game today, according to Corian.
Wow.
Every game except the last one.
Yeah. Denied. Taken.
Well, still worked out in the end. And yeah. Now they have Tassadar. And we had Tassadar as a ban last game, so...
Yeah, so that's the reason they did not take it.
Exactly, and now he's in there. Possibly their strong suit if Hasa and Zocca can play him.
Possibly. So this might be a situation of one of them needing to pick something else if they need to bring out a more interesting pick. Yeah, I'm very excited to see what they pick. I'd like this to be a Bloodlust comp, but NFAC have already let me down with that today. Rhaegar! Please be Bloodlust. It might just be they have to ban Nova now, just to make sure that they can Bloodlust, because you would otherwise take Ancestral Healing just to protect whoever gets engaged upon by Tyrael. You'll take Ancestral to just heal up that person, remove the burst. But I think you just take the lumps at this point and you you do the blood dust now that Nova is out the picture if they ban her, which I'm almost positive they will.
Now let's see. Well, they didn't get the... I'm kind of confused why they didn't ban Uther instead of Stitches.
Because Stitches is really annoying. Yeah, I'm expecting so, that's why.
It's one of those heroes that either you can deal with him or not at all. Okay, ban Anubarak.
It's exactly what we expected. They're probably going to ban Rhaegar now. Nova now.
Nova.
And they have their assassins in the form of their pseudo-assassin Tassadar and Tassawabs with Bloodlust, if that's what they go for. So they need. So they have their support, so they need warriors. So what's Vassal going to do? Limit their options. Now they're down to people like Chen and Diablo. They're a lot more limited in terms of warriors now. They have to go
second choices, not something you really...
specialists.
Yeah. But still, I think they could again go for that Zagara thing if they want to, but then...
Zagara's definitely open.
Yeah, she's out there, and you can play her a little bit more tanky.
She's actually a kind of a good idea with a Bloodlust comp, because if you oh no, that's a bad idea. I'm not happy with that idea, and this will be an instant Nova pickup by Fast Forward, if I'm not mistaken.
And Malfurion doesn't make sense with this composition.
Yeah, they already have a support too. So unless they want Nova, and they're really, really hoping Fast Forward doesn't take it.
Nova wouldn't make too much sense in that composition. Well, I mean, they already have Placid and Tychus.
Bloodlusted Hotshots Nova is actually kind of cool.
But that would be like the highest risk composition you could go for in this matchup.
I don't know, it's just so risky. If Fast Forward don't pick up Nova, then that's just insane, in my opinion. But I've been proved wrong today before.
Yeah, and also with the Rhaegar, with the Bloodlust combo.
Yeah, might be a bit more difficult. But the thing is, if you take down Tychus or Tassadar in this comp, then that's one less thing that's Bloodlusted. I don't know, this is risky. I do like Zagara in this comp, like I was saying earlier, though. Oh my god! Where's Nova?
Felstead?
Yes.
Okay.
If Nova's not their last pick, I will be astounded. Please just take Nova. Just to still my beating heart.
And Felstead? I mean, on other maps, sure, but on Garden of Terror?
It's kind of nice on Garden of Terror because it's so big. To help your team a bit, but... It's still interesting. I'd still rather they took Nova.
Maybe you'll see her. Come on.
If Nova's not picked this game, I will be astoundedly stupefied.
Come on, pick Zagara. I want to see her again. Zaka. Pick Zagara.
I like Zagara because you can get the Devouring Maw down, which bunches up a load of people. Then you get the Archon Splash. It's basically the hero's version of the Archon Toilet.
True. Too bad Abathur is banned.
Yeah, double Archons. Well, you have Tychus. You can launch his skill shots at his skill shot in Odin at it.
Yeah, just keep him close by. Have the Tychus.
Activate the Odin. Fire the missile. Fire the missiles. And, just see what you can do.
Okay, Kumba says Vel'Gol Mirrodin. I don't think so.
No. Unless...
Well, I mean, they do...
Mirrodin Archon Bloodlusted. Every auto-attack stuns.
Yeah, they need stun.
They do need hard CC. They have a knockback.
That'd be so crazy. I haven't seen Mirrodin forever.
I have seen him once. It didn't really work, but... I'd like to see it again. I'd like to see it work. Oh my god.
They're really taking their time.
Yeah, timers please. Blizzard. Come on now.
But I'm still confused about the Felstead pick before anyone else. Like, even if they're not going for
Nova. Nova's not here yet. I am amazed.
You love your Nova.
ETC? ETC?
Yes!
Okay,
yeah, it's a good pickup.
The Revenge ETC! I'm so
It's
happy.
A good pickup.
It's a warrior. They used it Fast Forward didn't really use it that well last time. They missed a lot of their ults. If Well Met can play it well, it's a very high stun warrior. which could really, really work in a situation. It's what they need. They need some hard CC. And ETC, his passive grants attack speed.
Oh man, that would be crazy. Bloodlust and ETC passive? Sonya?
I'm sorry, what?
Okay.
You have okay. to. That's a very all-in comp. It's going to be CC until it's going to be. Sonya Tyrael is actually a bit more common than you'd expect. It's the whole idea of just going in and bursting someone down as quick as possible, especially with Faustad. But
I'm not sure if I can agree. It feels like it's a sustained composition.
Well, it's about going all in a sustained thing. It's very much an all-in strategy, especially with someone like Faustad. But it is so risky, and now I'm really interested to see what Wellbet's playing. They have one more option, and it's likely to be a second warrior. Sonya has been... that might have been why they picked up Sonya. Just to remove a bit of CC and remove a bit of engage potential. Which leaves... that leaves Wellbet with basically two warriors, and that is Chen and Diablo. If they choose to go for a warrior.
I don't think they're going to pick up Diablo. Maybe Chen. I don't know if they've...
Yeah,
they have the experience
with Muradin as well, but let's be honest, who's going to pick Muradin? Please pick Muradin and prove me wrong. That would be amazing.
No, they already have ETC. What? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Okay. Yeah, just to make a fool out of the caster right then and there. Jeez.
Yes. This is the best team comp I have ever seen. Go Wellbet. You have earned my support.
I mean, I'll just go ahead and tell you guys. Okay, we have Ban Stitches, Ban Malfurion by Wellbet. Then we have some usual pickups. Tychus, Tassadar, Rhaegar. And now comes the crazy shit. ETC and Muradin.
Oh, Hiruki left. No, you started without Hiruki!
Oh, thank God, DC. They did cancel. Oh, jeez.
Good lord. That almost went badly.
Close call right there.
Yeah. Oh dear. That was close. That almost went really bad.
Yeah. Shit, you learned Nessie too.
This is true. All right.
I was going to talk about the picks by fast forward. We have bans on Abathur and Anub'arak. They picked Arthas and Tyrael as their warriors and Sonya later on. So Arthas, Tyrael, and Uther, usual, all good. Then you have Sonya and Faustad. So
yeah,
let's see how that works out. But both of the teams have three solid heroes and then just three really weird heroes because of their bans.
Yeah, this is if we're going by standard meta, fast forward, like you said, it's three solid heroes per team and then two, what is this, picks. For fast forward, it's the fact that they have a Sonya. Mostly just the Sonya and then another Faustad. The fact that you just have three warriors is the most important thing here. Just like scrapping another thing. It's like, why would you have three over two? They're just going hugely tanky, I think, just to try and deal with the Bloodlust. But Bloodlust excels at dealing with tankiness. I'm really hoping it is a Bloodlust comp. I've been proved completely wrong. Whereas, this is just weird.
For the first time around, we have a little bit of a switcheroo going on as the blue team on the left side here on what? Garden of Terror, we have Fast Forward, and they have Arthas in their team, they have Sonya, they have Faustad, they have Uther, and they just ported back, and they have
They just threw a load of abilities out for style and then beat back. And on the right hand side, in the red trunks, it is well met, we have Hiruki on the Rhaegar. We have Sokke on the Tassadar, Pozenclown on the ETC, Nomi on the Muradin. And Asimovs is playing the Tychus. This is my favorite game I have cast so far.
Yeah, and this is the final of the 8th ESL Community Cup, mind you. So kind of weird final compositions. But then again, the two top contenders are not participating this week. SK and Mind Sanity both not playing.
It's true. And the number three competitor going out early to fast forward. So this is a very good this is a very good game. And I'm so excited about this game. Like, you have no idea how hyped I am just because of the face. What is SebKR doing? Look at the dance.
Very fast pickup here on the easy camp by by Fast Forward.
Well Met attempted to gank bot lane. Nomi missed his stun, and Poison Clown couldn't get in there in time. So they're going to back out and look for a pick somewhere else. Actually, no. They're going to
stay. Thought about it. They thought about it. It's a little bit risky.
Oh, SebKR. Nope.
Don't do that to a Falstad.
He gets forward. Such reactions.
Looks like Fast Forward wants to go for a gank on their own, but not on Rhaegar. Not on Rhaegar's watch.
Rhaegar, wolf form. There's the totem.
Oh wow! Nice.
So good. He almost got killed by going back in, but that was so good. The reactions in this game are so good.
Incredible mind play, running back and forth. He knew that the cold strike was gonna come, and he just dashed back and got himself safely behind the wall.
This is the most excited I've been about zero kills at 1:40 I've ever been.
Okay, a little bit faster level 4 here. Four well met, but nothing to worry about yet.
And phase shift.
Yep.
Leaving it to the and last Hasselhoff second, saves and now Hasselhoff is going on to Vonga.
But Zarka still in trouble. Falstaff is onto him. Grenade? There comes the shield.
No, it's gone. Hasselhoff is out of stuff to use. There's the stun from Ufa. Saihei are going in, and Hasselhoff goes down. The too much greed. And somehow, Vongala was able to escape there. Nomi going in on Marco win instead of Saihei. I did not know Saihei was there. So that is the first kill going over to Fast Forward.
Yep, nice first kill. Tychus got a little bit too greedy right there.
Yep. Too greed.
But nice saves by Zarka beforehand. Oh, we have Murdin coming in.
Oh my god.
Falstad with the save.
Nomi is still chasing. Saihei is here to try and save Nomi. SebKR are dropping low. Muradin gets the kill.
Now Nomi should jump out there. There comes the shield.
Oh, there's the jump bait.
Nice save.
Go down and Nomi able to escape on the Muradin. There's his passive popping. He's going to grab Fountain. He's going to be healing up very quickly. And that evens up the kills, although he pushed it pretty close.
Yeah, he did. But amazing save. Muradin always able to get out there just in time. And that works especially well if you have these really tight-knit fences like here on Garden of Terror.
Oh, Marco win. This Vetkov is so good at ganking, but they did abandon mid lane there to try and get that kill and get some XP, but now they're going to roam down and they're going to take this Shambling Terror.
Yeah, they're losing some XP there in the middle. Falstad has taken that, and ETC moving out of position as well. I think they're going to grab Falstad here, maybe. Maybe not.
ETC is just wandering into mid lane because his bot lane is pushed. Does not want to get caught up by being too pushed up when it's pretty obvious that Fast Forward are taking that bottom Terror. So he's just going to soak the mid lane, wait for his team, which are now going to get here and kill the hard camp.
Force and Cloud nice bright.
For some reason.
Oh, looks like they can get... maybe a little bit too late here.
They won't fight. They're just going to go clear up the mercenaries that Fast Forward was able to pick up. And they've already... Oh, that's what ADC was being. Already going for their planter, and he's going to take that top lane as quick as possible. We can see Fast Forward reacting as quick as possible to that. Sokei was engaged upon by Saihei, and now Saihei dropped a lot of his abilities on that, so he's not going to have as much to CC the Plant Terror for quite a while now.
Oh, they soloed up Klaus and Clown. They need the remainder of the team up here as well. And there comes the attack on the top lane.
Yep, that bolt went down super quick, but they need... Well Met needs some more people here if they're going to have a chance of doing this. Nice route onto Poison Cloud, but here's the engagement. The healing totem is down as well, so that's actually going to help Sokke here. And they're trying to get damage done, but now we're finally going to see Fast Forward be forced to back up a bit because of Hasselhoff and Sokke.
Yeah, so much damage output here with Sokke and Hasselhoff's really helping out the Plant Terror here. But oh, Falstad moves in as well, and now they can push it back. And they even singled out the Plant Terror now. Poison Cloud is in a little bit of trouble right there, but he saves himself.
Yep, he is getting the... He's still getting the job done. He did take down some walls. He's probably going to get a Polymorph on Devongala. Yep, And he will have a bulb before he expires in 14 seconds. There it goes. Can he protect it? Throws down the polymorph. Isn't going to get anyone. But now here comes the engaged Nomi going onto Sai here. Hasuob's knocking it back as well. But Ufa does heal him up. He gets polymorphed. Nomi's still here. Sebke is just poking from over the wall.
Oh, they need to retreat out of this, but they want to get the kill. Whoa, nice job. Thousand Clown getting right on top of everyone there.
For well met, they're going to keep pushing this. And it's the knockback by Muradin, the insect. But now Sahir is actually too far back for them to catch. And they're going to chase him down. They do.
Hasuob's completely out of position, though. Hasuob's really wanted to go for these kills, or at least stop them. Wow, nice job. He gets out of there. And did they get the pickup on Arthas? Yes, they did.
Yeah. Once again, I'm left disappointed that it's Ancestral Healing that's been taken by Rhaegar and not Bloodlust. But we do still see a Mosh Pit and a Haymaker from Muradin. So, as much as I am disappointed, it's still going to probably work out for them. They're actually doing a good job here, and they have a slight level advantage, and they're the first team to take down a four.
Yeah, in the convincing fight, ooh, that's actually a little bit dangerous, but the office is there, so they knew that everyone else was out of position, they could do it. And the easy camp, wow, they take a long time to take this easy camp.
This is indeed the case, and I would like to point out, because there's one thing we really have to do in this game, and that's because we're seeing so many alternative picks, we have to talk about the talents. So, on ETC, we see he's gone for a bit more of a defensive build. He has gone for Block to protect himself, and he's gone for Groupies, which means that he heals his teammates with his guitar solo. He's also gone for a much larger range and knockback on his face melt, which will keep him alive for a bit longer. And on the Muradin, we can see that we have perfect storm.
Amazing drop back there from ETC, keeping Arthas on the right side, and I think they can just catch him off guard here. Oh no, no way to body block him. Hasuob's has to use the Odin.
Oh, and great mosh pit, catching three there, and this is a huge fight. Nice shock and awe though, there's the Tyrael ult, and down goes Tassadar, but Hasuob's is still full health inside that Odin. He's just bursting people down. He's been killed out of Odin. He's going to be able to dash back, though, and get some damage done. And it's a 2-for-2 fight. Tigers almost gets picked off.
They might get Arthas, though. They might get Arthas. Rhaegar comes in there, and he gets the kill. The remainder will get away, though. Wow.
So good. And a bit of that, I'd like to point out, was down to the fact that Nomi somehow has... Where is he? He only has 6k hero damage, despite the fact that he's taken Perfect Storm, which increases his Stormboat damage by 5 for each time he hits someone, and he hasn't really hit it that many times.
Okay. But I do like that they put a little bit more into sustain with ETC, like team sustain, so since they have to counter that 3...
Oh, Sebkeia.
Can they get him.
Oh, he's gone.
Oh, Interior's in trouble as well, but Arthas moves in, and also...
Oh, Muradin jumped as well, but Gela's able to back out, but huge engagements there by Muradin. The knockbacks into the body block are fantastic.
Oh, ETC's in trouble, he's going to be picked off later. That comes to Ancestral Healing, keeps him up alive, and... Whoa, the storm, the CC, good job.
Well, they are a bit too low here, though, for this engagement, so this is not going to go well. There's the judgment onto Tychus. But Tychus has popped his first aid. He still has Odin. He's still going in. Hiroki is standing on the back, healing up. Muradin finally goes down, but so does Sonya. And somehow, well met, take this fight. Pause the Cloud did not get hit by that shock and awe, and he's able to get out alive as well. Hiroki also survives. It's down to Sebkeia, who is forced to back up. He will get out alive.
Wow, amazing shielding here by Zaka. He really kept Hiroki alive. Without him, I don't think they would have won that fight. The Ancestral Healing just came in time. And they have just amazing sustainabilities with this composition.
This is a fantastic comp. It's working really, really well for them. Like you said, huge sustain, huge engagement, and amazing chase potential. The ETC Muradin roaming comp is doing fantastic, even with Faustad, who has some of the most escape in the game. They're still picking him off almost every time.
Yeah. All right. They can move down now, can grab the easy camp, no worries, and the plant is growing. So we're going to see the next pushing attempt here pretty soon by Well Met. And ETC is going to jump into the plant.
Yep, ETC was in the plant last time. I'm just going to go over a couple more of the talents before we get an engage here on Sonya. We can see the fact that she's gone for a bit more of an aggro build, increasing her hammer damage on her seismic slam and giving herself a bit of healing with ferocious healing by spending some of her fury. That just gives it healing for free for 10% of her health. And she's taken an increased spear range. She is very much the engager, healing herself, dealing some damage, and with leap, she is a perfect engaged person. But both teams, now if they're terrors, they're going to head out onto the map and try and do some damage. And I'm quite concerned about Porcelain Clown's choice to go top lane. It looks like he's just going to use it to clear the wave, and it's now going to fight in the mid lane.
Yeah, mid lane is going to be a little bit of a push here. Biowarmat incoming. Oh, well, maybe not a little bit. Porcelain Clown is in there, so he can get some damage done. Oh, nice stun there on Sonya, but they're not going to single him up. They're going to try to get Tyrael, but he gets away. No real chase here. Nomi tries to chase off, but he's missing from the main fight. I don't know if that's the right idea here. They're already going for the fort.
Yeah, Muradin has come back. He's looking for an engage, but there's no one to engage upon. They are going to get this fort, though, but incredibly good job here by Nomi. Seriously separating out Tyrael, forcing him to be and removing him from that fight for the time being, and he is just destroying in this game, but he still hits Marco Wynn due to the fact that his stun, thanks to his piercing bolt, can hit two people.
Yeah, there's just steamrolling over this entire lane right now. They have the T Giants in the back, and they do a decent amount of damage. Tyrael tries to get in there again, but they get puts out so much damage on him. He's shrunk now, and there comes the storm. They try to body block him. Can he get away? Oh, he has to step by the plant.
Sonya just died to Nomi.
Wow.
This comp is so good! And well met are just crushing through this. They still have 7 seconds left on the plant terror. Then use it to throw down another bulb, get a little bit of damage. They're actually going for the core.
Wow, I don't know if this might be overextending it, but...
I think it might be as well. There's a Divine Storm catching two. Where's the mosh pit? I haven't actually seen it go down yet. There it is!
There it is!
Catching two! Marco Wynn and Seb KR, and they're not even going
to
kill him.
But the core's up to 5%, and that's it! Wow.
Holy crap.
How the heck did that work out? I think, wow, that was just an amazing way to play this out.
That was incredible. Well met, taking some of the least picked warriors. Picks we haven't seen before, and or at least seen once. I think we've seen ETC once, and I think we've seen Muradin once, and making them work, doing a fantastic job. And they take, in a 2-0 victory, the ESL Community Cup number 8.